Hello and welcome. You're watching NewsX. I'm Megha Sharma, and let's continue our conversation about the two big alliances who are at this point of time their leaders coming from the length and breadth of the country and holding those important integral meetings. Joining me on the telecast is Ashif, and give us details, Ashif. You are at Mallikarjun Kharge's residence. The meeting has now gotten over, and if you could tell us what exactly was discussed in the meeting.
देखिए, मैं आपको बताऊं कि मल्लिकार्जुन खड़गे की जो आवास पे मीटिंग दस राजा जी मार्ग पे थी वो खत्म हो चुकी है, और वहाँ बैठक के बाद वो तमाम लोग धीरे धीरे बाहर निकल रहे हैं, लेकिन उस बैठक में जो तस्वीरें सामने निकल के आई वो बड़ा ही अलग अलग था। मैं आपको अगर सिटिंग अरेंजमेंट की बात करूँ तो राहुल गांधी के दाहिने साइड में एम.के. स्टालिन और बाएं साइड में अखिलेश यादव बैठे हुए थे। मल्लिकार्जुन खड़गे के बगल में शरद पवार, एक तरफ सोनिया गांधी बैठी हुई थी, शरद पवार के बगल में तेजस्वी यादव बैठे हुए थे। ये मैसेज देखिए, मैं सिटिंग अरेंजमेंट इसलिए बता रहा हूँ क्योंकि यही मैसेज होता है कि इंडिया गठबंधन में किसकी उपस्थिति किस तरीके से है और कौन से लोगों पर कितना भरोसा करके कांग्रेस पार्टी आगे बढ़ रही है। देखिए, इसमें तमाम चीज़ें, पहले तो उन चीज़ों के आकलन हुआ कि हमने कहाँ कहाँ चूक की और किस किस तरीके से गलतियाँ रही जिस पर हमको दूर करने की ज़रूरत थी। अगर हम इकट्ठे होकर और मजबूती से अगर आगे बढ़ते, हमने अगर और अच्छे तरीके से मैसेज कन्वे किया होता तो हो सकता है कि नतीजे हमारे और हमारे फेवर में होते। तो ये सबसे पहली चीज़ ये थी। दूसरा कि अभी भी क्या क्या गुंजाइशें बची हुई हैं, किस किस तरीके से लगातार अप्रोच किया जा रहा है।
Prime Minister has arrived at Kartavya Path and heading to the Rashtrapati Bhavan. Prime Minister Narendra Modi has arrived at Rashtrapati Bhavan for the farewell dinner that has been hosted by President Draupadi Murmu on the occasion of the completion of the 17th Lok Sabha and the new term that is going to be undertaken by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Okay, Manohar Kesari, if you have, okay, we'll try to get Manohar Kesari. Kanika Katyar on the telecast with me. Kanika, those are visuals of Prime Minister's cavalcade, which has now arrived at Kartavya Path at Rashtrapati Bhavan.
देखिए मेगा, बिल्कुल साफ तौर पे एक और अगर देखा जाए तो एनडीए की बैठक हो चुकी है, लेकिन सरकार जो है नई बनाने से पहले जो राष्ट्रपति एक फेयरवेल डिनर देती हैं उसके लिए प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जो है वो भी पहुंच गए हैं लगभग जो है कर्तव्य पथ से होते हुए। लेकिन एक और एनडीए की बात करें तो एनडीए की बैठक जो है वो समाप्त हो चुकी है, वहाँ पर फेयरवेल डिनर की बात चल रही है, लेकिन दूसरी ओर लगातार इंडिया अलायंस के तमाम जो नेता हैं वो अभी भी बैठक में मौजूद हैं। हालांकि बैठक जो है वो औपचारिक रूप से जो है फिनिश हो चुकी है। हालांकि कुछ देर में कहा जा रहा है मेगा कि जो जयराम रमेश हैं शायद वो यहाँ पर आकर मीडिया से बातचीत कर सकते हैं, लेकिन अभी इंडिया अलायंस के जो तमाम नेता हैं वो मल्लिकार्जुन खड़गे के आवास पे अंदर मौजूद हैं। हालांकि हमें थोड़ी देर का इंतज़ार करना होगा क्योंकि साफ तौर पे जब बाहर निकलेंगे तो एक जॉइंट फोटोग्राफ जो है वो रिलीज़ की जाएगी। उस फोटोग्राफ में कैसा कॉन्फिडेंस होगा इन नेताओं का वो देखने वाली बात होगी। उसके अलावा अगर मीडिया से बातचीत करते हैं कोई भी नेता तो क्या कुछ रहेगा इस बैठक में, क्या अंदर इतनी लंबी जो चौड़ी बैठक की गई है उसका इनपुट क्या निकल के आया, क्या कुछ निकल के आया, उस पे सबकी निगाहें टिकी हुई है। लेकिन एनडीए की बात करें तो एनडीए की मीटिंग खत्म हो चुकी है, फेयरवेल डिनर के लिए प्रधानमंत्री जो है राष्ट्रपति भवन पहुंचने वाले हैं और उनके साथ तमाम जो एनडीए के सहयोगी दल हैं वो वहां पर मौजूद रहेंगे। एक और एनडीए जो है नई सरकार बनाने से पहले सेलिब्रेशन कर रहा है, फेयरवेल डिनर इंजॉय कर रहा है, लेकिन वहीं दूसरी ओर इंडिया अलायंस जो कि विपक्ष की पार्टियां हैं वो कहीं ना कहीं आगे की रणनीति को लेकर जो है आपस में मंथन करती हुई नजर आ रही है। हालांकि जो औपचारिक बैठक है वो अंदर खत्म हो चुकी है, आपस में जो अनऑफिशियल कॉन्वर्सेशन होते हैं नेताओं के वो चल रहे हैं, लेकिन कुछ देर में तमाम जो नेता हैं वो बाहर निकलना शुरू हो जाएंगे और हमें भी इंतजार उस पल का रहेगा कि जब ये लोग बाहर निकलते हैं तो इनकी तरफ से क्या बॉडी लैंग्वेज देखने को मिलती है और क्या कुछ बातें जो है वो मीडिया के सामने रखते हैं।
जी बिल्कुल कनिका, यहाँ पे अपडेट आ रही है कि जयराम रमेश कांग्रेस के वेटरन लीडर हैं, वो मीडिया को संबोधित कर सकते हैं कुछ ही समय में।
देखिए बिल्कुल साफ तौर पे कांग्रेस पार्टी के महासचिव और कम्युनिकेशन डिपार्टमेंट के महासचिव हैं जयराम रमेश, वो कहा जा रहा है कि मीडिया से बाहर आकर बातचीत करेंगे, लेकिन उसकी संभावनाएं अभी हालांकि औपचारिक रूप से कोई ऐलान नहीं किया गया इस चीज़ का, हमें वेट एंड वॉच रखना पड़ेगा। वेट एंड वॉच की सिचुएशन में हम भी हैं और दर्शक भी हैं आमतौर पर, लेकिन जो बैठक है वो खत्म हो चुकी है साफ तौर पर, और अंदर अभी तमाम जो नेता हैं वो आपस में हाई टी इंजॉय करते हुए नजर आ रहे होंगे, और इसके बाद जो है कहा जा रहा है कि जयराम रमेश के चांसेस हैं कि वो बाहर आए और इस मीटिंग के ऊपर एक ब्रीफ जो है वो मीडिया के सामने रखें कि आखिरकार जो 27 दल के जो इतने नेता यहाँ आके बैठे हैं आपस में क्या रहा और इंडिया अलायंस की इस बैठक में क्या कुछ खास बातों पर चर्चा हुई है। तो इंतजार उस वक्त का करना होगा जब जयराम रमेश जो है वो बाहर आते हैं और मीडिया से बातचीत करते हैं।
जी बिल्कुल कनिका, यहाँ पे कल की बात करें, सारे के सारे जो आपके बड़े नेता हैं, रीजनल पार्टीज़ के लीडर्स हैं, कुछ चीफ मिनिस्टर्स हैं, कुछ अध्यक्ष हैं, वो सब इस समय दिल्ली में हैं, चाहे वो ऑपोजिशन से हो, इंडिया अलायंस से हो, चाहे वी टॉक अबाउट द एनडीए अलायंस। यहाँ पे अब कल के क्या प्रोग्राम्स होने वाले हैं, क्या कुछ मीटिंग्स अरेंज की गई हैं जगनमोहन रेड्डी और सॉरी नॉट जगनमोहन रेड्डी, वी टॉक अबाउट चंद्रबाबू नायडू और नीतीश कुमार, क्या उनकी मीटिंग्स प्राइम मिनिस्टर के साथ कुछ ऐसी प्लान हुई हैं या होम मिनिस्टर से मिलेंगे वो?
देखिए बिल्कुल मेघा, अभी एज सच इस बारे में कोई जानकारी तो हालांकि नहीं है, लेकिन बिल्कुल जो दावा एनडीए की मीटिंग के बाद किया जा रहा है सरकार बनाने को लेकर, उसके बाद हो सकता है चांसेस ये रह रहे हैं कि इसके बाद भी एक अकेले में प्रधानमंत्री से मुलाकात हो। हालांकि मुलाकात का ऑलरेडी दौर जो है खत्म हो चुका है, एनडीए की बैठक में नीतीश कुमार भी शामिल थे, चंद्रबाबू नायडू भी जो शामिल थे, और इससे पहले भी ओवर द फोन जो है प्रधानमंत्री बातचीत कर चुके हैं। हालांकि वो प्रधानमंत्री नहीं रहे हैं, दोबारा उनको शपथ लेनी है तीसरी 3.0 के लिए, लेकिन नरेंद्र मोदी की ओर से ऑलरेडी नीतीश कुमार से बातचीत कल भी की गई थी, आज वो बैठक में शामिल थे। हालांकि अभी ऐसी कोई जानकारी हमारे पास नहीं आई है कि कल क्या एक बार फिर से बैठक का सिलसिला रहेगा या नहीं रहेगा, लेकिन ऑब्वियस सी बात है कि अगर वो रुकते हैं और उसके बाद जो कल का शेड्यूल होता है उसके अकॉर्डिंग चीज़ें प्लान आउट होंगी, और जाहिर तौर पर जब तक सरकार नहीं बनती है, जब तक सरकार बनाने का जो दावा है वो राष्ट्रपति के सामने नहीं होता है, ओथ सेरेमनी नहीं होती, तब तक लगातार हमें जो ये बैठकें हैं वो देखने को मिलेंगी, क्योंकि अलग अलग नेता जो है वो अलग अलग लीडर से मुलाकात करेंगे, चाहे वो इंडिया अलायंस की बात हो चाहे वो एनडीए की बात हो, क्योंकि इंडिया अलायंस के नेता भी आज कई लोग दिल्ली में रुकेंगे, तो हो सकता है कि यहाँ पे भी कल जो है हलचल देखने को मिले। और इसके बाद
ये तो समझ आता है, इतना तो समझ आता है कि जो एनडीए अलायंस के मेंबर्स हैं स्पेशली जगनमोहन रेड्डी, स्पेशली चंद्रबाबू नायडू और नीतीश कुमार, वो तो समझ आता है कि दिल्ली में रहेंगे 48 आवर्स या उससे ज़्यादा वो रहेंगे, उनको कुछ यहाँ पे डिस्कशंस करनी होंगी, नेगोशिएशंस करनी होंगी, एनडीए में उनको कौन सा पोर्टफोलियोज मिलेंगे, क्या उनके स्टेट के लिए स्पेशल स्टेटस या स्पेशल पैकेज दिया जाएगा, उसके बारे में बात करेंगे। पर जब हम बात करें इंडिया अलायंस के मेम्बर्स के लिए, उसमें अब ऐसी क्या बातचीत रह गई है जिसके लिए ये लीडर्स को यहाँ पे रहना पड़ेगा दिल्ली में?
देखिए बिल्कुल साफ तौर पे मुझे नहीं लगता जाहिर तौर पे कि जो इतनी लंबी चौड़ी बैठक ऑलरेडी जो इंडिया अलायंस की हो चुकी है उसके बाद अब कुछ भी चर्चा के लिए एज सच बचता नहीं है, क्योंकि साफ तौर पे एनडीए के पास बहुमत है, एनडीए दावा कर चुका है कि हम सरकार बनाने जा रहे हैं, चंद्रबाबू नायडू की बात हो या फिर नीतीश कुमार की बात हो, बार्गेनिंग और डीलिंग जो है वो पहले से कर ली गई है। हालांकि उनको जो ऑफर दिया गया या जो उनकी तरफ से डिमांड्स रखी गई हैं, अब उन लोगों को आपस में नेगोशिएशन करना है। लेकिन इंडिया अलायंस की बात करें तो इस बैठक के बाद तय होगा कि आगे की जो स्ट्रैटेजी है वो क्या रहेगी। कल की बात प्रिडिक्ट करना आज बहुत मुश्किल है मेगा, हालांकि हमें आज का ही इंतजार करना होगा जब ये मीटिंग खत्म होती है उसके बाद क्या कंक्लूजन निकल के आता है, लेकिन साफ तौर पे इस मीटिंग में जो भी डिस्कशन हुआ होगा अब वो फ्यूचर स्ट्रैटेजिकली चीज़ों को डिस्कस किया होगा कि अब इंडिया अलायंस इंटैक्ट होके कैसे जो है आगे लड़ेगा, क्योंकि जिन मुद्दों को वो उठाता रहा है कैसे उन मुद्दों को उठाएगा, और खासतौर पर एनडीए सरकार पर लगातार इंडिया अलायंस जो है तमाम आरोप भी लगाता रहा है, तमाम मुद्दे उठाता रहा है, उन तमाम पहलुओं पे आई एम श्योर इस बारे में चर्चा हुई होगी, लेकिन अभी इंतजार करना होगा मेगा, क्योंकि जब औपचारिक तौर पे मीडिया से बातचीत होगी तभी ये चीजें क्लियर हो पाएंगी कि एक्चुअल इस मीटिंग का रिजल्ट क्या रहा, क्या ये मीटिंग सिर्फ बैठकर बात करने के लिए थी या वाकई कोई स्ट्रेटजी विपक्ष के पास है जो वो प्लान आउट कर रहा है।
जी बिल्कुल, हमारे साथ बने रहिए आप कनिका, लेट्स हॉप ऑन टू What is happening at the Rashtrapati Bhavan at Kartavya Path. My colleague Manohar Kesari is at Kartavya Path right now, witnessing all these developments that are taking place. और मनोहर हमें बताइए, अब प्राइम मिनिस्टर की कैवलकेड ऑलरेडी वहाँ पे पहुँच चुकी है, प्राइम मिनिस्टर राष्ट्रपति भवन पहुँच चुके हैं, डिनर का जो सेरेमनी है वो अभी शुरू हो चुका है।
देखिए बिल्कुल 8 बजे राष्ट्रपति का जो डिनर पार्टी थी वो शुरू होनी थी। कुछ ही देर पहले प्रधानमंत्री का काफिला यहाँ से गुजरा है, प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी राष्ट्रपति भवन पहुँच चुके हैं। उससे पहले अमित शाह, राजनाथ सिंह, ये तमाम जो काउंसिल ऑफ मिनिस्टर्स के मेंबर्स हैं वो पहले ही पहुँच चुके थे और डिनर पार्टी शुरू हो गई है। कुछ देर के बाद में हम आपको बताएंगे कि आखिरकार डिनर पार्टी भी किस तरह रही। हालाँकि मोदी 2.0 की आखिरी विदाई डिनर पार्टी है। एक परंपरा रहती है कि जब सरकार जीत करके आती है और नई सरकार का गठन होता है तो पुरानी सरकार को जो है सो इस्तीफा देना पड़ता है और राष्ट्रपति जो है अपनी ओर से एक डिनर पार्टी का आयोजन करती है। उस पार्टी का आयोजन शुरू हो गया है, लेकिन सबसे बड़ी बात है कि अब जो व्यूअर्स देख रहे हैं, सिर्फ डिनर पार्टी नहीं, व्यूअर्स को अब इंतज़ार है कि सरकार का गठन कब होगा, सरकार में कौन कौन मंत्री बनेंगे। तीन सब की भी चर्चाएं आज जब एनडीए की बैठक हुई थी तो एनडीए की बैठक में प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी को सर्वसम्मति से जो है सो नेता चुन लिया गया है, जिसमें 17 घटक दल जिसमें बीजेपी शामिल है के नेता शामिल हुए, चंद्रबाबू नायडू, नीतीश कुमार, चिराग पासवान। उसके अलावा अगर हम बात करें तो अलग अलग पार्टियों के जीतन राम मांझी हमसे शामिल हुए, तो सभी लोग शामिल हुए और अपनी सहमति उन्होंने दिखाई है। 7 जून को एनडीए की संसदीय दल की बैठक होगी, उसमें 1-to-1 मुलाकात होगी, जो सरकार का विजन है वो बताया जाएगा। क्योंकि जो आज प्रपोजल पास हुआ उस प्रपोजल में आप साफ तौर से लिखा हुआ है कि सरकार ने जो जन कल्याणकारी नीतियाँ लोगों तक पहुंचाई उसी का ही जनादेश उन्हें मिला है। और जो सरकार की थीम है कि जो गरीब हैं, शोषित हैं, युवा हैं, दलित हैं, वंचित हैं, उनके लिए सरकार काम करेगी। तो जो कई नए सांसद भी चुन करके आए हैं उनसे भी 1-to-1 मुलाकात होगी, कई राज्यों के मुख्यमंत्री और उपमुख्यमंत्री भी उसमें शामिल रहेंगे। तो कहने का मतलब ये है कि 7 जून को सरकार बनाने का दावा पेश कर सकती है उस मीटिंग के बाद। और खबर ये है कि 8 जून को मोदी 3.0 जो है सो फॉर्मेशन में आ जाएगी, शपथ ग्रहण लिया जा सकता है। जी
ओके, ऑल राइट मनोहर, थैंक यू फॉर गिविंग अस दोज अपडेट्स। एंड ऑफ कोर्स यू नो द पार्लियामेंट राइट नाउ, द साउथ ब्लॉक बिहाइंड हिम इज ऑल लिट अप, इट्स अ ब्यूटिफुल साइट टू बिहोल्ड। एंड इज देयर, आई मीन ऑफ कोर्स देयर अ पॉसिबिलिटी for that the PMO is then going to release those pictures of the dinner that is now currently underway at President Murmu's residence, Rashtrapati Bhavan. I come back to my panelists, and Sumit, a response from you first about the meeting that has been held today. It's a span of 48 hours. 7th June is when the leaders of India of NDA Alliance are going to be coming together and staking claim, heading to the president's residence on 7th of June. So there is a time period of 48 hours during which these negotiations will be hectic and finally a consensus be built.
Megaji, this is now, you see, India has given, or the Bharat has given a mandate to the NDA Alliance under the leadership of Prime Minister Modi. BJP is controlling 240 seats out of the alliance. So, I mean, lion's share is with BJP and it is the mandate of Prime Minister Modi. Yeah, unfortunately, there was a bit of a setback in UP and West Bengal. Otherwise, the BJP on its own would have got the mandate. So this is an opportunity for the NDA leaders either to be more relevant, to be more into participation in the government. They all know they have a say right now, but they can't. They all know what is the Lakshman Rekha. They all know they can't negotiate too much. Getting a reasonable stake, getting a reasonable share in the governance is what they will look at. But if you look at Chandrababu Naiduji and if you look at Nitish Babu, they are interested more in running their respective states. They are not interested in coming to center. So it should be a smooth sailing. There should be no issues at in any way whatsoever. And in due course of time, you will see more and more parties will join the NDA bloc. So NDA, which is looking to be around 295 today, with due course of time, this NDA will start becoming bigger and bigger and bigger. And you know, the challenge with India Alliance is they are just doing a meeting, which is like a which is like an Alice in Wonderland show. They're trying to say we will be in power, because they know sand dunes need cement and Sharia to be intact. So to keep their sand dune intact, they're trying to actually tell them, oh, we'll get power, we can form a governor, we can form a government. What do we need to do? If NDA is not able to form the governors, if Nitish backs out, if Naiduji backs out, then it's our chance.
There's very much a clarity at this point of time that the opposition opposition accepts it cannot form a government. What they at this point of time are rejoicing over is that they have gotten a stronger vote share and seat share from the last time around, and they become a stronger opposition against the NDA, against the government of India, and that's how the deal is. And also about, you know, there's been so much criticism by the opposition against the government of India that there is this blanket passage of bills and acts which up until now did not have the stamp of the opposition, because they were so few in number in the Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha. But now with an alliance of the NDA and more number of MPs that are from the opposition, the likelihood of getting a full absolute support for the bills that the BJP passes is going to be perhaps lesser. Advocate Manasvi Thapar, I think the focus is not so much on the India Alliance meeting that lasted for about two and a half hours, but the shorter meeting that happened within the NDA Alliance members, where Prime Minister Narendra Modi and Chandrababu Naidu and Nitish Kumar were the key constituents of that meeting. And of course, I'm again going to drop, you know, the cost of being repetitive, the demands, the desires of Chandrababu Naidu and of Nitish Kumar. Chandrababu Naidu, I have to talk about Amaravati. I have to talk about the special package that he will be desiring of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and of course his dream project, something that had been shelved by Jagan Mohan Reddy when YSRCP came to power. It's again in the hands of Chandrababu Naidu, and so strongly with the vehement majority that he got.
Correct. Megha, please allow me uninterrupted time. The most important part, what we are going to see this is that what was told earlier, that Khichdi Sarkars don't work out. This is the time, this is the testing of Narendra Modi ji's Khichdi Sarkar now. So how is that going to pan out? Obviously, you can debate on the fact that UPA 2 was a larger Khichdi, this was a lesser Khichdi. Khichdis are Khichdi, and these two Khichdis also have a different angle to this. The alliance partners, which are depending upon the TDP and the JDU, both have been betrayed by BJP, and they have also betrayed BJP in the past. So you can't have a 100% trust on your alliance. So every day there is a idea that today they may leave, tomorrow they may leave. You have to. So now what you have to do is you have to make sure that the machinery is well oiled. You are well versed with them on every point. You have to go by their demands. You have to respect their alliance. So what was happening prior to this mandate was, BJP did not respect the alliances. BJP did not respect the alliances which were there. So that kind of narrative has to be changed. Has to not only changed optically in realistic values, and also giving what the what the alliances want has to be done. And also with BJP, the bigger fear which the alliance partners have had in the last 10 years was that they break their MPs. They break their parties into two or three, create multiple camps and tell them to join BJP. So that is also a fear that would mostly be with the JDU. The kind of poaching BJP does, that has to also be controlled. So these things would also be in the back of the mind of the alliance. But having said all this, so it's a great opportunity for our country. This is a great opportunity for Prime Minister also. Why do I say that? It's because he has a good track record of last 10 years. There is a vision which Prime Minister Narendra Modi has. The credibility of the Prime Minister coming for the third time cannot take away his credibility. Obviously, he had put a larger benchmark for himself that I want to cross 400 on his face. There is very interesting thing which I was Googling when I came to know about this thing, that in 2014, I'll show you one thing. This is Modi ki guarantee ka manifesto of 2024. Now, I go back to 2014's manifesto. There were 10 other leaders. Ek Bharat, Shrest Bharat was the manifesto of BJP. There were 10 other leaders in that manifesto. And when I come to 2024, it's only the Prime Minister and the President of BJP. So then larger than life figure, that only Modi can win election and only Modi is needed for BJP. BJP is nothing apart from Modi. That narrative also needs to be thinked upon. Since last 10 years, I have been telling that it is the Congress which has to go to their whiteboards and think back what have went wrong. And it is now, for the first time, I have to say, it is the BJP which needs to go back to their whiteboard and think what went wrong. Or that statement that we don't need RSS or we can just win on one particular phase, that has to be thought about. So it's BJP which needs to think, because there are two elections coming up, Haryana and Maharashtra, in the next few months. And Maharashtra looks like it is going to go the Shiv Sena, NCP and Congress way, which is a kind of poaching which they had done. They have given the life to NCP and Shiv Sena. Had it been the case, they would have not broken these two political parties. The Marathi Manus would not have woken up. They have woken up and they feel that BJP, which is an outsider party, which is right now the largest political party in terms of the Vidhan Sabha numbers, has broken up our two major political parties. So that is some that fraction is going to be larger and larger. So all these things are going to be a somersaulting turn for BJP now.
Okay, all right. Eski Datta, how do you view what Advocate Manaswi Thapur has said? Yes, there is a reality check that has been given to the BJP, that has been given to Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will have to be more malleable to the demands and the desires of the other alliance members. Something similar that had happened in 2014, but there was an absolute majority that had been gotten by the BJP, 282 seats. This time around, it is, how much is it, 240? 240, a little more than that. So here, you know, the malleability, the flexibility will have to be shown by the BJP and the Prime Minister.
Didn't need that much time. Let me come to a few things in a very clear cut way. This is for sure that 2024 is definitely not a mandate for Shriman Rahulji and Hindi Alliance to form the government. It is a mandate for them to sit in the opposition. They should gracefully do this. Till yesterday night and today morning, they were trying all their level best with 99 MPs to poach on the NDA, thinking that the Bharatiya Janata Party is out here to do kirtan without any anti-poaching device. The Indy Alliance is much more vulnerable. That vulnerability has been seen today. Uddhav Thackeray, till yesterday, he was storming the town that Rahul Gandhi ji should be the prime minister. Today, he was missing from the Indy Gadbandhan meeting. He had sent in his bacha, Sanjay Rao, to be a part of the meeting, and he had declared that he would fly down to Delhi, didn't come. So a lot of pot is boiling in Maharashtra, and I have been seeing this for quite a while now, and I have said this also during the time of the election and especially from the day of the counting, because I do have concrete informations to say that something very unforeseen is going to happen in Shiv Sena Uthav side very soon, and things can work out in a different way. So can it happen with NCP. Now let me come to the legality. The NDA has already passed a resolution confirming its collective faith on the Honorable Prime Minister's leadership in the NDA meeting. This will be given in writing either tonight with a letter of support by the NDA partners to the Honorable President of India. And on the 7th, there would be a meeting of the NDA in the morning, the parliamentary meeting of the BJP and of the NDA in the morning.
Yeah.
The leader of the house would be chosen by the NDA, and the PM would stake his claim for forming the government.
The PM is taking the Prime Minister is taking claim to form the government on 7th of June. There is a period, there's a lag period of 48 hours when there are going to be negotiations that are going to be held. I'm just quickly going to reflect on the screen with the visuals that are coming. That is the India Alliance meeting that has now gotten over. And there you see Rahul Gandhi. We have D. Raja over there. We have Akhilesh Yadav on the left. We have Sharad Pawar on the left hand side. We also saw just a while ago Raghav Chadda was also present, as there is this show of strength that is happening right at Mallikarjun Kharge's residence. So that has the meeting lasting about 2.5 hours is now completed. I'm going to get in Aditya on the telecast with us, but there is currently likelihood that Jairam Ramesh is going to come out and speak to the media. There has already been a message that has been sent out by Rahul Gandhi as well, and remains to be seen, of course, what is the opposition's agenda. Now they are a stronger opposition than they were in 2019. So which are these points that they will come together and fight against the BJP, against the NDA? And the big question amongst all these India Alliance members, they have come about, and they're from TMC to DMK, RJD, Samajwadi Party, every single party representative is here except for Nitish Kumar, who founded the India Alliance. But he, of course, now jumped ship and became part of the NDA, and in fact became part of the winning party, winning alliance, and will be able to get the pound of flesh that he desires from the BJP. All right. I have with me Nikhil Jain as well. And Nikhil, quickly a response from you about, and I'm particularly focused right now on the India Alliance. The meeting has been held, and it's heartening to see that India Alliance members, they've all come together. All right, before I come to you, Nikhil, I'm being joined by Aditya. Aditya, the meeting is, Kanika Katyar on the telecast with me. And Kanika, give us an idea of what's happening. We see that these are visuals on the screen. The meeting has obviously gotten over, as is visible right now on our screens. Very soon these leaders are going to disperse.
देखिए बिल्कुल NewsX आपको एक्सक्लूसिव दर्शकों को तस्वीर दिखाना चाहता है कि इंडिया अलायंस की जो बैठक है वो ऑलमोस्ट खत्म हो चुकी है, क्योंकि औपचारिक जो बैठक है वो खत्म हो चुकी है, लेकिन तमाम जो नेता हैं आप देख सकते हैं वो बाहर खड़े होकर जो है बातचीत कर रहे हैं, जिसमें आप संजय राउत को देख रहे होंगे संजय सिंह से बात करते हुए, वहीं राघव चड्ढा जो हैं वो कल्पना सोरेन से बात करते हुए नजर आ रहे हैं। इसके अलावा तमाम जो अलग अलग नेता हैं, अखिलेश यादव जो है वो संजय सिंह से बात कर रहे हैं, वहीं अगर बात करें तो अभिषेक बनर्जी जो है वो राम गोपाल यादव से बात करते हुए नजर आ रहे हैं, यानी कि हर वो अलग अलग तरह से बात करते हुए नजर आ रहे हैं। और कुछ देर पहले बल्कि राहुल गांधी भी इस वक्त यहीं पे थे, जो कि वो तेजस्वी यादव से बातचीत कर रहे थे और उनका हालचाल भी उन्होंने पूछा, और एक मुस्कुराते हुए जो है कॉन्वर्सेशन राहुल गांधी और तेजस्वी यादव के बीच में चल रही थी। हालांकि इंडिया अलायंस की बात करें तो ये बैठक जो है वो खत्म हो चुकी है और तमाम जो नेता है वो इस वक्त यहाँ पे मौजूद है, आपस में बातचीत करते हैं। और देखिए बॉडी लैंग्वेज अपने आप में बहुत कुछ बयां करती है, क्योंकि जो बॉडी लैंग्वेज अभी इस वक्त इंडिया अलायंस के नेताओं के बीच में दिख रही है वो ये दिखाती है कि जो ये 234 का मार्ग वोट जो सीटें जो है इंडिया अलायंस को मिली है, कहीं ना कहीं ये नेता जो है उन सीट से बहुत ज़्यादा खुश है। इसी खुशी की अगर आप बात करें तो मेघा आप इनके बॉडी लैंग्वेज को रीड कर सकती हैं, इनके चेहरे को रीड कर सकती हैं, जो तमाम नेता हैं वो आपस में बात करते हुए नजर आ रहे हैं। हालांकि हमें थोड़ा इंतज़ार करना होगा कि क्या वो मीडिया से बातचीत करते हैं और इस बैठक का सकारात्मक जो है रिजल्ट क्या निकल के आया है उस का हमें इंतजार करना होगा। लेकिन मेघा बिल्कुल तस्वीरें अपने आप में रोचक हैं, आपस में ट्विनिंग जिस नेता की जिसके साथ है उस ट्विनिंग के जरिए जो है वो बात कर रहे हैं, चाहे वो अखिलेश यादव हो, वो राम गोपाल से बात कर रहे हैं या संजय सिंह से बात कर रहे हैं। वहीं अगर हम मैंने बताया आपको कि जो किसी वेणुगोपाल हैं वो एमके स्टालिन से बात कर रहे हैं। इसके अलावा देखिए किस तरह डी राजा जो हैं वो भी एक ग्रुप में खड़े हैं, जिनके बगल में अखिलेश यादव और संजय राउत खड़े हैं, संजय सिंह खड़े हैं, राम गोपाल यादव पीछे खड़े हैं, वो सब भी आपस में बात कर रहे हैं। तो मीटिंग ओवर हो चुकी है, एक हेल्दी और एक लाइट वे में कॉन्वर्सेशन का जो राउंड है
बिल्कुल यहाँ देखने को मिला है। हम देखा जाता है यहाँ पे कनिका, जब इलेक्शन नहीं हुई थी, कैंपेनिंग चल रही थी, कैंपेनिंग से पहले भी जब इंडिया अलायंस का गठबंधन हुआ था, यहाँ पे एक ह्यूज शो ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ किया गया था। पिछले बिगिनिंग के जो मीटिंग्स में थी वहाँ पे ममता बनर्जी ने अपनी प्रेजेंस फेल्ट कराई थी, पर बाद की मीटिंग्स में ममता बनर्जी का कोई प्रेजेंस नहीं दिखा। और आज उन्होंने अपने नेफ्यू जिन जो कि हैं अभिषेक बनर्जी, उन्होंने इलेक्शन जीता है, अभिषेक बनर्जी को भेजा है, जो कि एक बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग सिंबलिज्म है, क्योंकि इससे पहले अभिषेक बनर्जी कभी इस मीटिंग में नहीं आए थे। यहाँ पे देखा जाए ममता बनर्जी के जो सक्सेसर होंगे, उनके जो एयर अपेरेंट होंगे, वो अभिषेक बनर्जी ही होंगे।
मेगा, बिल्कुल मेगा, मैं आपको बीच में रोकना चाहूंगी, इस चीज के लिए माफी मांगूंगी। देखिए साफ तौर पे देखिए इंडिया अलायंस के तमाम जो नेता हैं वो फोटोग्राफ देते हुए नजर आ रहे हैं। अपने आप में ये एक शक्ति प्रदर्शन जो है वो इंडिया अलायंस नेताओं की ओर से किया जा रहा है। तमाम जो नेता है, देखिए न्यूज एक्स आपको लाइव ये तस्वीर दिखा रहे हैं। शरद पवार बीच में खड़े हैं, उनके बगल में जो है अखिलेश यादव हैं, डी राजा हैं, उसके बाद संजय सिंह है, के सी वेणुगोपाल खड़े हैं, उसके अलावा तमाम जो पार्टी के अन्य नेता हैं वो भी खड़े हैं। राघव चड्ढा बल्कि इस मीटिंग में मौजूद हैं। इसके अलावा अगर हम बिल्कुल आपने जिस बात का जिक्र किया कि ममता बनर्जी, तो ममता बनर्जी जो है वो आज इस बैठक में नहीं है, लेकिन अभिषेक बनर्जी को रिप्रेजेंटेटिव के तौर पर उन्होंने भेजा है। क्योंकि रिप्रेजेंटेटिव की बात करें तो अभिषेक बनर्जी चुनाव जीत कर यहाँ पे आए हैं। देखिए मल्लिकार्जुन खड़गे जो कि कांग्रेस पार्टी के राष्ट्रीय अध्यक्ष हैं वो इस वक्त यहाँ पे आ गए हैं। और मेघा ये न्यूज एक्स आपको एक्सक्लूसिव तस्वीरें दिखा रहा है किस तरह से पूरा इंडिया अलायंस एक साथ। और देखिए सोनिया गांधी जो है वो भी यहाँ पहुंच गई हैं, उनके बगल में कल्पना सोरेन जो है वो यहाँ पर है। उसके अलावा अगर बात करें सुप्रिया सुले वो भी इस बैठक में है और शामिल हुई थी। और देखिए सब नेता जो है वो अब एक वाइड फोटोग्राफ के लिए बाहर निकले हैं।
और यहाँ पे ऑलरेडी पिक्चर सर्कुलेट हुई थी कुछ टाइम पहले मीटिंग के अंदर की शॉट से। यहाँ पे अगर आप बता सके प्रियंका गांधी वाड्रा यहाँ पे नहीं दिखाई दे रही है।
देखिए बिल्कुल जो अंदर के विजुअल्स आए थे मीटिंग के वो भी अपने आप में दिलचस्प विजुअल थे, जिसमें अखिलेश यादव जो है राहुल गांधी के बगल में बैठे हुए थे और उनके बगल में एमके स्टालिन। और ये केवल एक फोटोग्राफ नहीं है, ये एक मैसेज है। जो परफॉर्मेंस अखिलेश यादव, राहुल गांधी और एमके स्टालिन की रही है, तमिलनाडु में एमके स्टालिन की पार्टी ने बहुत अच्छा परफॉर्म किया है, यूपी में अखिलेश यादव की पार्टी ने अच्छा परफॉर्म किया है, वहीं राहुल गांधी ने भी कांग्रेस पार्टी की ओर से अच्छा परफॉर्म किया है। तो वो एक तस्वीर दिखाती है कि कैसे ट्विनिंग नेताओं के बीच में बनी हुई है। हालांकि राहुल गांधी की ट्विनिंग जो है वो अखिलेश यादव और तेजस्वी यादव से बहुत पॉजिटिव दिखती है। लेकिन मेगा आज हम इस तस्वीर की बात करना चाहेंगे क्योंकि ये तस्वीर अपने आप में रोचक तस्वीर है। हालांकि देखिए मल्लिकार्जुन खड़गे जो कि ये बीच में खड़े हैं और वो अब प्रेस से बात करने वाले हैं।
जी बिल्कुल कनिका, यहाँ पे बात करें जो जौन से लीडर्स ने, जौन सी पार्टीज ने अच्छा परफॉर्म किया है वो मेन फोकस थे। राहुल गांधी की बात करें, आप बात करें डीएमके के लीडर एमके स्टालिन की, आप बात करें अखिलेश यादव की, वो ओके लेट्स लिसन इन टू व्हाट मल्लिकार्जुन खड़गे इज सेइंग।
मैं सभी हमारे जो गठबंधन के लीडर्स हैं उन सबको नमस्कार करता हूं और आप सभी का स्वागत करता हूं। जो हमारे गठबंधन पार्टी के नेता लोग 2 घंटे तक बैठकर आज के पॉलिटिकल सिचुएशन पे और आज की जो परिस्थिति है उस पर बहुत से सजेशन आए, चर्चा हो गई और ये निष्कर्ष आखिरी में ये निकला कि हम सब मिलके एक ही वॉइस में ये कहना चाहिए जो मैं आपको पढ़ के बताऊंगा। द कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट्स ऑफ इंडिया ब्लॉक थैंक द पीपल ऑफ इंडिया फॉर द ओवरवेलमिंग सपोर्ट रिसीव्ड बाय अवर अलायंस। द पीपल्स मैंडेट has given befitting reply to the BJP and their politics of hate, corruption and deprivation. This is a mandate in defense of the Constitution of India and against price rise, unemployment and crony capitalism and also to save democracy. The India bloc will continue to fight against the fascist rule of the BJP led by Modi. We will take appropriate steps at the appropriate time to realize the people's desire not to be ruled by the BJP's government, and this is our decision and we all together agreed on these points and will definitely whatever promises we have given to the people, that we will keep it up. And just I want to tell this. Thank you very much.
Sweet, the speech that he has made, he's attacked the BJP. He said that the opposition India Alliance has come together in defense of the constitution, price rise, crony capitalism, fascist rule of the BJP led by Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and said that India Alliance is going to take appropriate steps to ensure that there is democracy that prevails in the country. All right. So Nikhil, on the telecast with me, of course, you know, a big show of strength. This is optics, and optics is on which politicians play. And that's what India Alliance is also doing right now.
Absolutely. And Megha, no matter who's meeting who right now, I really think that there might be a chance that Chandrababu Naidu and Nitish might shift their allegiances to the India Alliance. Of course, the India Alliance would have to be very swift on it. So there have been a lot of questions as to why is the India Alliance holding a meeting now? They don't have a shot at forming the government. But let's look at the numbers. If you take out the 28 of the NDA, of the JDU and the TDP from the India Alliance and NDA Alliance pretty much are around the mid-260s. None of them are crossing the majority mark. And at that point of time, both of them would have to scramble for other parties to join in. Now, the reason that I feel this might be possible
is that's twofold. That's where you're wrong. You're calculating it over here. Let's put out the facts. The fact is that BJP is at 240, NDA is at 295. There are 28 seats that are provided by the TDP and the JDU. Now, if you remove the 28, of course, they don't have the majority. But at the same time, it is the opposition India Alliance with 234. Even if you add up the 28 seats, you're still not crossing the halfway mark.
Exactly the point I'm making, that if JDU and TDP are both to shift to the India Alliance, we'd be left in a hung assembly situation where neither the NDA nor the India Alliance would be reaching the majority mark on their own. So further some, you know, maneuvering would have to be done by either of the alliances to form the government. The reason I feel this is possible is twofold. Number one, if you look at Nitish Kumar's politics, and if you look at TDP's, Chandrababu Naidu's politics, that has been traditionally secular politics. They have been strong opponents of Narendra Modi in the past. Number two, for any political party, it makes non-national political party, regional party, it makes more sense to be part of a coalition that where the lead party has 99 MPs rather than be part of a coalition where the lead party does have 240 MPs. They obviously have more power, they have more negotiation, they have more say at the table, and this is what every regional party would want. And add to that, what the Narendra Modi government, or rather the BJP under Narendra Modi in the past 10 years have done, breaking up, Manasvi touched on that as well, that they were going around breaking parties, they were going around getting symbols to other people, all sorts of things they've done to, cause a lot of hurt to other regional parties. Nitish Kumar himself, do we not remember the 2020 Bihar elections? What happened with Chirag Paswan contesting against Nitish Kumar on the seats where JDU was contesting while also being part of the NDA, while saying, Mere man ke andar Narendra Modi hai, which essentially led to a situation where Nitish Kumar lost out on a lot of seats. BJD and YSRCP have been supporting this government in the Rajya Sabha on the contentious bills that they've been passing, and look what has been done to them by the BJP and the end under Narendra Modi. Therefore, it is in the best interest of every regional political party to be part of the India Alliance, which is why you never know. And one might say ki abhi to Pradhan Mantri milne wale hain.
The chances are very, very real that the YSRCP is going to be in the NDA fold, that the BJD is going to come in the NDA fold. There are, and the likelihood of it is going to be seen in the next 6 months to 1 year.
No, but with how many MPs? 5 MPs. And also, let's not remember that
you already have the majority of 295, and every single seat after that counts.
No. I'm being very honest. I think there is no chance of an India government if TDP and JDU both do not shift to the India Alliance.
But that's what I'm saying. It is not to the benefit of the TDP and the JDU to go away from the India Alliance. Because if the government falls, what is the guarantee that India Alliance is going to win the election? I mean, they would rather be on the side where they are being given the people's mandate, their desires and demands are going to be fulfilled, then to be hung assembly, then to have a midterm election, or then to be breaking this entire cycle, and then gathering their wits and saying, listen, we are again for the mammoth task of holding the elections. What are the chances that India Alliance is going to come to power this time around if the elections were to be held right now?
That's not how it happens. If the government that the India Alliance forms is to fall, there'd be a new floor test and they can jolly well go with the BJP and be part of an India Alliance without there being any need for a fresh election.
Nikhil, why is it not happening then? You think India Alliance does not have that option?
No, India Alliance is obviously trying to quote these ladies as was Narendra Modi and the BJP was trying to do them. Let's not remember that just a few hours ago when Nitish Kumar landed on an airport and all the reporters were crowding around him and asked ki NDA ki sarkar banegi India ki, he just went with a smirk on his face saying sarkar to banegi hi, instead of clearly saying no, I am with the NDA or I am with Narendra Modi. Let's not forget TDP has scheduled a press conference
ambiguous a statement that had been made by Nitish Kumar, it is in contrast as clear as day that there has been signatures of the top NDA alliance partners, which includes number one, TDP, which is Chandrababu Naidu, number two, Nitish Kumar, with 13 or 14 of those seats. And then you have Eknath Shinde, whose signatures have been put on a document, on an official document, which says that there is full support that all these political parties are going to give to Prime Minister Narendra Modi to form Modi 3.0 government.
Similar documents were also placed when Ajit Pawar had taken up the post of Deputy Chief Minister and Devendra Fadnavis had taken up the post of Chief Minister at 8 in the morning, and we all know what happened the next day. See, this is Indian politics.
Okay. Let me try to figure this out, because the math does not work for me. If the TDP and the JDU were to withdraw support from the NDA, from the BJP right now, it is to their detriment and not to the detriment of the BJP alone. I'm going to come back to you, Sumit, and get a response from you on this.
Megaji, the point is very simple. Look, Chandrababu Naidu and Nitish Kumarji are seasoned politicians. Do you think they want to take out the support and hang in lurch, hawa mein latak jayenge, hoping that Rahul Gandhi has mercilessly dismantled his party, was dismantled his state government, was dismantled his cadre, who has latestly sacrificed Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary, and who has just lost 390 MLAs and around 240 MPs so far. You want to trust your luck on that person? And who is in India Alliance? So you will leave a block, which is Modi ji 240, and go to Rahul Gandhi and start negotiating with him, who has a Guinness Book World Record of losing maximum number of elections on planet Earth. So I don't want to use this word, you should be crazy to do this. Rather than, you have to wait and watch, Megaji. Why question them? Why Mamata Banerjee is not coming to all of your meetings? Why Uddhav Bhau has not come to your meetings? And let's hope that the NDA, so-called NDA alliance and the government is formed, how many of them are going to remain with the NDA? How many of them are not going to jump the ship? Is it a formal alliance? Okay. Is it a pitfall alliance? Is it an alliance with the agenda? None of these things are with NDA alliance. They are just giving them a Junjunov, we can form the government so that we have some cement to the alliance. Okay. Because Rahul Gandhi knows after some days there will be nothing called India alliance.
Advocate Manasvi Thapar, would you like to respond to this? What is the probability, 1 out of 100, that there is going to be a probability that India Alliance could form a government, that the TDP and the JDU will withdraw support from the BJP, from the NDA?
Megha, allow me uninterrupted time. There are infinite possibilities in this, after this election. Why do I say that? There is no natural alliance. It is all an alliance. All the alliances, be it of NDA or India, are alliances of opportunity, alliances to how do individually we cater to our political ambitions. It's not a natural alliance. This is not UPA one or NDA
one. Fair enough.
Where the alliance fall, we fall together and we don't join another alliance. It's an opportunity. A plain and simple, this is for the first time in Indian history, plain and simple opportunistic alliances are being seen. Till the time our opportunity or something is given to us, we are happy. We stayed with you. If we are not happy, we may go anywhere. And there is no ideology left right now in this particular batch of political alliances. So we have to take it. It's a pinch of salt or a pinch of sugar. I don't know. But the reality is this is an alliance. These all alliance partners are alliances of opportunities. So it's all okay. Everything is fair in love and war. And I believe politics is neither war and love. It's in between somewhere. But the bigger question is, so now there is a skill of alliance ka dharam, which Narendra Modi ji does not know how to cater to, because in the last 22 years, from being a chief minister to the prime minister, a very credible leader he has been, because that's why you get such a long tenure. So this skill he does not have. It's either his way or the highway. He does not like to share his particular boardrooms or ideologies with other political leaders. And now for the first time in his political career, he is short of a mark. So how will he cater to that level of alliances, make sure they are happy, make sure his idea of vision, which he wants to work on, has to be upgraded. This was a skill which was unacquired. For the first time, that's...
But would you agree, Manasvi, that, you know, when you take the two... I'll come to you. When you contrast and compare the India Alliance members, the parties are far too many. And when we talk about the BJP alliances, the NDA, the parties are much lesser. So the stability is a possibility on the NDA alliance side and not on the India alliance side. And it will be the demands that the BJP will have to cater to and manage will be from the two particular parties, as compared to what is in the India alliance, which has a lot of political parties, regional parties. From Aam Aadmi Party, you have Samajwadi Party, you have Mamata Banerjee, you have the RJD, which has unfortunately performed dismally, and several others.
So Megha, now this is very interesting. Why? Because these two alliance partners have broken away in the past. They don't have a very good relationship with BJP. So they can break away anytime. And now the other part of interesting part here is, so the Alliance of India, they have a common minimum project that we don't want Narendra Modi as the Prime Minister. They don't have any other thought as of there in their mind. So earlier, 2 days back, I was saying that cannot be a mandate to fight an election, that you want to remove one particular person as the prime minister of your country. That cannot be the reason to go and ask for votes. But I think that turned out well for them. And now that's the only common factor and favicol factor for them, which is like which the present government has used, the ED, CBI against the opposition leaders. That could be a reason they joined hands together. And now that is the reason they're together. So this will keep them, that if we are not together, Narendra Modi will come, he'll bring out ED, CBI, he'll make sure that our bank accounts are frozen. They don't get that political freedom which they enjoyed during the UPA two times.
Okay.
So earlier it was said that ED, CBI...
Can I make a small point?
I'll just take 30 seconds. So now, so you can't trust TDP, you can't trust JDU, and JDU can't trust BJP, or TDP can't trust BJP. Why? Because BJP is the greatest poacher in political history. So today, JDU MPs can be tomorrow's MPs of BJP. Today's MPs of TDP can be MPs of BJP tomorrow. So there would be a
huge... In the history of politics, even in the Congress, when there were coalition governments were formed, there were times then there was Jayalalitha who took away power from the BJP government. There have been times that Sharad Pawar took away the power from the coalition that was led by the Congress. So this has happened several times, and this will continue to happen as long as politics survives in the entire globe. Sumit, you want to make a point before I come to SK Datta?
Just like 30 seconds. Look, here is BJP with 240 seats. For Nitish Babu, you come, you will negotiate with Prime Minister Modi and try to get something. There you have 99 Congress, then you have 36, 34, and then you have all chota mota parties. Where does your negotiating power come? Whom are you going to negotiate with? So will a Rahul Gandhi first consider Akhilesh Yadav, then Mamata Didi, then DMK or Nitish Babu or TDP? Here it is Modi ji, Nitish Babu, TDP. Wahan toh aapka number 10th number pe aayega. So logically, and that too, after that, you don't know where you're going. You're still
exactly,
might be hurting
exactly.
Large. Why? Nitish Babu has always aligned with the ruling side. Jaha power hai. Where is the power today? Uncertainty is power.
Agree.
What will the same politician
do? It is plain
do?
Math. It is logic. I mean, you are contending in India Alliance with Samajwadi Party, with the Congress 99 and then 33, and then you have DMK at 22, and then Mamata Banerjee at about 31, and then it is the TDP that is at what, how many seats? 16 of them, and then you have JDU, which has about 12 or 13 of those seats. So I mean, it's a very logical, very smart decision, and that has been made, And it is a pre-poll alliance. It's not a post-poll alliance. Yes, Sumit, Nikhil, you want to make a point?
See, the point that Sumit made, that is exactly the difference between the NDA alliance led by Narendra Modi and BJP and the India alliance led by the Congress. That one is NDA alliance is one where there is just one man. Aapko kuch bhi kaam karna hai, you have to go to Narendra Modi. That's the only option that you have. However, the India alliance is the deliberative process that represents a democracy, that when you have to take a decision, you have to sit at a table with 10 other people, taking 10 other views, and then reach a balanced decision. And let me remind your viewers that the UPA one was one of the most phenomenal governments when it came to giving rights to citizens, like right to food safety, Manrega and all of that. It was a great government in terms of the economic management. RTI, RTE, so many, Manasri, I can't even list right now. But the point is, at that point of time, Congress only had 144 MPs and the BJP had 136 MPs. So even then, it wasn't that the Congress was a very strong party, but they managed to run it well because they know the essence of democracy and having these consultative
processes.
Why
are questions being raised that a coalition government of the NDA this time around is not going to perform? All right.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel, hit the bell icon.